What is going on, guys? Welcome back to yet another video. In this video, we're going to discuss why you should not buy BCAAs and why you should instead consider EAAs, essential amino acids. So make sure you stay tuned. So as part of like a new take on videos, I'm gonna try making it shorter, easier to digest videos, just cutting through the shit, basically. So there are 20 amino acids, a mixture between non-essential and essential amino acids. There are 9 essential amino acids, so 9 out of 20 are essential. You need to get them from food, your body cannot synthesize them, and you need them to build muscle. BCAAs only contain 3 of these essential amino acids, so leucine, isoleucine, and valine. They contain 3 of them. 3 alone is not enough to build muscle, to actually increase protein synthesis. So you need all 9 to increase protein synthesis and build muscle tissue. But BCAAs are not completely worthless. They have actually been shown to reduce the rate of muscle breakdown, which is a good thing. So 2 things lead to growth even, reduction of muscle breakdown and an increase in protein synthesis. So BCAAs can do one of these things, can reduce the muscle loss, let's say, provide an anti-catabolic effect, but if you wanted to do that, you could actually just introduce some carbohydrates, like a teaspoon of honey can do more or less, I'm not gonna say exactly the same, more or less the same thing, provide an anti-catabolic effect and give you energy. Some people say that BCAAs give them energy.
Large black coffee.
Do you mean a venti?
While they work out, so you can use the honey instead. So you need all 9 in order to build that muscle protein. You need all 9 in order to increase protein synthesis. So in 2017, Rob Wolf conducted a study and showed that BCAAs provide 0 anabolic effects. So they don't provide any effects in terms of building muscle, which pretty much puts a stamp on what I just said. For those of you who don't know, Rob Wolf is one of the biggest protein researchers out there. He has done numerous studies on essential amino acids. He's known as the amino doctor, in fact, so you can imagine. Some people say that there's some conflict of interest, but in the same study, he also showed that EAAs do have a significant effect on muscle protein synthesis. But there is a big but. To be honest, when people taking like amino acids of any sort see the biggest benefits and when their protein, overall protein content is low and that kind of boosts it through the amino acid consumption. So that's one thing. So if you're a vegan and you're supplementing on essential amino acids, you will see a significant effect. You will notice a difference in recovery. I personally use essential amino acids while I work out, easier to drink than a protein shake that's kind of milky flavored. And not only that, I find they do give me a boost. They give me that extra bit I need in the gym. It might be in my head, but I'll take it all day and every day, even that little tiny percent, but they do boost the blood content of amino acids. So if you haven't eaten for hours and hours before, which I don't eat like 2 hours before I work out, then they do provide a little boost of blood amino acids and can provide energy as well to help prevent breakdown. So when you leave that workout, you're not just fighting that muscle breakdown, you're in kind of like a medium state. It does vary from person to person. They're not a magic supplement. I mean, I would definitely preference protein powder over essential amino acids. Essential amino acids are lower down the chain, whole food over protein powder, but generally speaking, people do need the assistance of protein powder, and it's super convenient when it comes to boosting protein intake, basically. So there is a very quick summary. Essential amino acids, they're expensive. They're more expensive than protein powder, so I put them kind of like 4th on the list after something like creatine. So I'd probably go with, if I'm going to give you a supplement list, I'd go with vitamin D3, protein powder, creatine, then essential amino acids come somewhere after that. It can be, I don't know, there can be other things I'd put first, it depends on the day, but they do give you that kind of like feel good factor while you work out. Like I said, I don't know if that's psychological. They have been shown to increase protein synthesis, which is a good thing. You know, protein synthesis is basically your body's ability to build muscle. The increase in protein synthesis is needed. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a massive thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, click that subscribe button below. And if you would like some one-to-one coaching online, get in contact with me, either adam@adamscottfit.com or www.adamscottfit.com. Reach out to me there, have a look at my site if you want. My main focus is helping skinny guys build the maximum muscle and building their confidence at the same time. So that is the path I walked, and that's the path I can help you on too. So until the next video, keep pushing the limits.